Hello and welcome back to Blockwell. We are down at the shop at the moment. Our bale has finally arrived. What we've got on hire for the season. We've got a crone for this season instead of the usual New Holland. And on the front of it, we've got our new tractor. So we've bought a class. But it's not the one we had on demo. They made us a offer we couldn't refuse on the next series up, which will handle the big bale a better as we've got quite a lot of contracting to do with it. So we're not too worried about having the accumulator or anything. So single bales all the way. We've got some hay to go and bale. It's a real big step up with power to what we've been used to. Give us a lot more scope for machinery investment now as we expand. It's back to a Renault-derived cab suspension system. Extremely comfortable. Don't know where they found this tractor, but it's done very, very little work. They refer to it as ex-demonstrator, but it's the old model. Get the neighbours' hay baled up. So fully equipped with RTK GPS as well. So we'll be looking at some bigger bits of kit to go with this tractor as the time comes. Now he's raked this up. Looks like somebody's got a new rake. Glad we aren't conventional bale on this. Hope this will take these swaths in first. They're big. Can see us missing bits here. Very, very good crop of hay now is in windrows. Thought that was good when we cut it, but this is our first time out with the crone baler. Said at the shop we've always had New Hollands or Hestons. We've just gone for something different this time. Didn't want the Heston because this gives a scoop for doing the haylage as well, and also silage if needed. You can wrap the bales, whereas you won't be able to do that if we'd gone Heston. nice to have enough power to do the job. If he was doing this with his welder, I think there'd be a problem. If we were using his welder to do it. I said this is about as high as capacity as we go with the baler. See that by the speed we're able to travel at. Bales. We have told him before about leaving too wide a swath. That's when we had the other baler. Now we've got to go and just clear these bits up. Anything? Or is it only complying? That figures. Doing a fair amount of straw with this baler as well come harvest. I think if we're going to bale the rest of these fields, I'm going to ask him to use our rake for that. Bale, not a self-propelled forage harvester. It's done a fairly tidy job nonetheless. Little heaps up. Go and get the other field done. So this tractor will take over from the New Holland's main tillage tractor. Probably not main drilling tractor. Unless we're on some steeper ground. Probably leave that in the hands of the New Holland still. Twine on board. It's full. lot of aisles there. I'm guessing he's hoping to use that for the rest of the field as well, so he's left it parked up here. That's a big heap. Steady. Let's have another sweep of that. We have a tidy up on here. That field isn't so bad by the looks of it. There wasn't as much grass on there when we cut it. I think I'd want a smaller tractor on here. It's just pulling up this hill. I think I could come around again and have a tidy up. There's left bits everywhere on these corners. It's near impossible for us to clear the field. Oh, he done that. The other one is fairly clean. It's got a big swath across the bottom to do. Never do I want that bale behind that again. If we had a round bale, that would be struggling slightly. That much hay in a row. Tighten this corner up. I did wonder if this tractor was going to be too big. Always better to have more horsepower than not enough. be so many barrels on this field. If we can go at this speed in hay, we're going to be flying in straw this year. We do all the straw for the pig farm. Oh, what he's done there. Certainly give the baler a test. First one of these balers in the area. So we'll see how it goes. If it's too much trouble to go back to New Holland. Yeah, it's done some random bale swaths on this field. We'll get a bit of drone footage anyway. Now sort of off the worst of it. Definitely some big swaths there. Not as big as on the other field, thankfully. Shouldn't be too much to clear up on here. Got a feeling this tractor's one they might have had in stock for a little while at another branch. Wander off the books. This is more than 100 horsepower more than what we were looking for. Less bales on this whole field now on one of those headlands. Clear these little bits up. Eject the barrels, all left in there. Still well keep that drone above them power lines. Alright, we're all done down here. Try and get that down that back road this time. Having the tractor this size should open up a bit more contract work to us with a potato grown neighbour. She often wants something large on the subsoiler. Does want a big tract on the trailer. If it turns wet for potatoes, we've got something as well. So we have helped him with them many times. First class tractor in the area as well. First new class tractor in the area, I should say. I'll raise a few eyebrows. So no one will know who's got it at the moment till they see it in my yard. One or two may guess who it is with the baler on the back. Potatoes looking well. Just hope we can get them bales cleared up before it rains. I'm not having anything to do with that bit. This is lookout. So our field to have a look at as well. Might just get them wrapped up with this. Get them wrapped next time, but for now that's where we're going to leave this video. So I'll say thank you for watching, hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you again in the next one. Goodbye for now.